It's like putting a 100-pound weight vest on and breathing through a straw and doing uphill runs, if you can imagine that.
So the hardest part, the whole thing is the hardest part.
It's fun in kind of a twisted way. It's really painful and hard.
They called it the toughest 2 minutes in sports at one time.
And they don't call it the toughest 2 minutes in sports for nothing.
There's nothing that puts you through a test like this.
And what we have here today is the Scott Firefighter Combat Challenge. We've been all the way from the East Coast to all the way to Carlsbad, New Mexico to Ontario, California this year.
I just had the idea that why not Silverwood?
Over 25 stops we're going to make this year. But here we are in beautiful Silverwood.
Yeah, here it is.
Competition's unbelievable. We got competitors from all over the United States.
Mike Brown, first-class firefighter from Kamloops, BC, Canada.
Ken Kapal, Spokane Valley Fire Department, Battalion Chief's team.
And what they're doing, it's really a complication of what they really do on the job. The physical fitness aspect of what these guys do each and every day is displayed right out here on this course. They'll step up to the start system, they'll have to remain motionless for 2 seconds, at which time it's going to count down just like it would on an HRA drag race. Once the lights turn green, the alarm goes off, they'll reach down and grab a 42-pound hotel pack, throw it on their outside shoulder, and go all the way up to the top of the tower. It's 41 feet from the ground to where their feet are at the top of the tower. They'll throw that hotel pack into a basket, lean over the rail, and grab a 5/8 inch sterling rope. Attached to the end of it is a 42-pound donut roll. They'll hoist all the way up to the top, over the rail, into a basket, and then they're gonna come all the way down. They can skip as many steps as they want on the way up, but they have to hit every single step on the way down. Once they come down the tower, they'll jump on top of the Kaiser forcible entry machine, where they're moving a 160-pound steel beam, a total distance of 5 feet, with a 9.6-pound shot maul. Once they move it to 5 feet, they'll put the shot maul down on the line mat. They will run through the delineator course. They'll reach down and grab an 1¾-inch Nidener hose. They're gonna drag that Nidener hose 75 feet through these saloon doors, open up that puck nozzle and hit the target until it goes down. At which point they throw the hose down and they'll head over to rescue Randy, a 175-pound, true-to-life, 6-foot-tall mannequin, and they're gonna drag him 106 feet across the finish line. And they're trying to get the best time.
The fastest guys do it in like a minute and a half, minute 40 seconds.
Of course, we're not pushing those time limits, us Chiefs here. We're kind of old, but it's a younger guy's competition, and it's pretty fun to watch them.
Most of us played competitive sports through our life, and then this is kind of a takeoff once we become men and still want to play like kids.
Yeah, there's some friendly competition to it, for sure.
It's just one of those things. It's what firefighters do, I guess, and we wanted to come out, show our support for everybody else, all the other firefighters out here doing it, so we thought, what the heck?
The camaraderie that's built across the United States with these competitors, and a lot of times they only see each other at these competitions, is unbelievable.
You know, it's a brotherhood, sisterhood, we're just one big family.
The team aspect of firefighting in general is amazing. To come here and meet all guys from all over the different places that do the same job as you, have the same passion for the sport and the job.
Firefighting's their passion, and this is a way to kind of just turn it loose and come out and use the skills that you've learned through all of your years in the fire service, and use it in a friendly competition.